Welcome to Developing with DocuSign. I'm in Bagazit with the Developer Center team. In this screencast, I'll go over DocuSign sample apps and showcase MySure, our sample apps for the insurance industry. I'll also demonstrate how to build it on your local machine. Sample apps are one of the ways we help developers learn about the DocuSign APIs. With sample apps, you get to see and interact with live versions of applications that utilize our APIs. All the source code for our sample apps is open source and available for you in GitHub. To find our sample apps, go to developers.docusign.com. From the black navigation bar, select More, then Sample Apps. Here you'll find all the sample apps listed in one page. This screencast will focus on MySure, our sample apps for insurance, but I encourage you to try our other sample apps. This is the homepage of MySure. It is designed as a self-service portal for consumers who either already have insurance or are interested in purchasing insurance. Let's try the free use cases that MySure demonstrates and see how they utilize various DocuSign APIs and features. First, let's try the leftmost option, Submit a Claim, by selecting the Get Started button. At this point, a pop-up dialog appears that lets the user choose how they want to log into this application. This app only uses the DocuSign developer demo environment. The first options let the user use their own developer account. It will require you to enter a username and password. The second options enabled anyone to use the app without providing credentials. It uses a pre-configured account that belongs to the DocuSign developer content team. I'll use the pre-configured account for this demo. Behind the scenes, your choice controls how the app authenticates itself with DocuSign. DocuSign requires authentication before it will authorize the app to make API calls. With your developer account, the app will use the authorization code grant authentication. With the pre-configured account, the app will use the JSON Web Token grant or JWT authentication. You can find out more about these authentication options if you follow the link at the top of the dialog. I click continue with the pre-configured login, then log in. Submitting the claims requires the user to provide some information. The information is used by MySure to generate an envelope. Envelope is the term that DocuSign uses for the data object that contains all the information and documents required for an electronic signature transaction. Once you fill out this form and select Submit a Claim, MySure will then make two API calls to the eSignature REST API. To learn more about these API calls, I click See Behind the Scenes on the right. The first API call to the eSignature REST API is used to create a new envelope. It adds all the required information to the envelope. This includes a document, a recipient, tabs which are sign-in elements or fields, and a subject. It also indicates that the envelope should be ready for signature right away by setting its status to sent. The second API call is used to support the embedded sign-in session. With embedded sign-in, the user can sign directly from your app or website without having to find the link in an email message. The create recipient API call is therefore used to generate the URL for embedded sign-in. Once the call is made, MySure redirects the user to that URL. At this point, the user sees the sign-in UI where they can interact with the envelope. The document that was sent to the first API call is shown to the users. As you can also see, the information from the Submit a Claim form populated the document. This document and the information associated with it is now stored in the DocuSign Agreement Cloud. The two elements in this interaction are the sign-in tab and an optional attachment tab. The sign-in tab lets user place the signatures on the document. The attachment tabs in this scenario is optional and lets the user add images describing the damage for which they are submitting an insurance claim to MySure. I sign the document and click Finish. When sign-in is complete, DocuSign redirects the user back to the URL which was requested when the app made the Create Recipient API call. This takes the user back to MySure. This sign-in complete page explains the various events that can be passed back to your application from DocuSign to indicate the status of the recipient interacting with the envelope. I click back to home to return to the MySure homepage. Now let's try the second use case of MySure. The automatic policy renewal is an option for consumers of MySure to allow their policy to be automatically renewed every 6 months. It is a way for consumers to consent to have their policy automatically renewed every 6 months. This feature uses DocuSign Click and the DocuSign Click API. DocuSign Click lets you capture consent to agreements terms, such as terms of service and privacy policies, with a simple click or a checkbox or button. You can display the click wrap in a seamless embedded experience on your websites and apps, or send the URL directly to your users. The way My Shoe works is that it creates a new click wrap every time you use it. This is done for demonstration purposes. A click wrap is used to generate agreements to be consented to online. To create it, the app is called the Click API and provides the documents to be displayed in the click wrap and a few other settings. For the API to generate an agreement from a click wrap, the app needs to provide the email address as a unique field to indicate the person agreeing to it. Once you select Submit for Renewal, the click wrap is created and the agreement is presented. Here is the click wrap agreement. I scroll through the click wrap, select the checkbox, and then click I agree to indicate consent to the agreement. These options were set when the click wrap was created. It was also set to require the user to read through the entire document, so until the user scrolls down to the very end of it, they cannot proceed. DocuSign records my consent to this agreement in the DocuSign Agreement Cloud. I click back to home to return to the My Shoe homepage. The last use case is buy new insurance. This scenario is similar to submit a claim as it uses embedded sign-in. It also uses additional features such as formula tabs to calculate the total premium that you need to pay for the insurance based on information provided in fields in the document. This option uses DocuSign payments to collect payment from the user. I select Get Started. The Buy New Insurance forms enable me to choose between auto, home, and life insurance. For this demo, I'm going to choose auto. I fill the form and select Proceed with Sign Up. At this point, MySure makes e-signature REST API calls to create an envelope and generate a URL for embedded sign-in. Then I'm being redirected to the URL that was provided by the e-signature API. This envelope has a document as well as some fields for the recipient to act on. The recipient can enter amounts for coverage and deductible, as well as choose to combine multiple types of insurance. The formula tab calculates the premium amount based on my selections. In these sample apps, we use a simple formula just to show the capability of calculated fields. Once I sign and select Finish, I'm asked to pay the premium. This feature uses DocuSign partner payment providers with a pre-configured payment gateway set up in the DocuSign account. In MySure, I enter 4242 four times with any expiration date and any security code. I select Pay and Finish. I see confirmation on my dialog box that payment was made, and I'm directed to the MySure Sign and Complete page. For the second part of this screencast, I'm going to show how to build and run MySure on your local development machine. The MySure GitHub repo is located at http://github.com/docusign/sample-app-mysure-python. This repo is open sourced. You can clone or fork it to jumpstart your development. You can also submit pull requests with contributions if interested. This code in the repo uses Python and the Python SDK on the back end to make API calls to DocuSign. The app also uses React on the front end and is served using Node.js web servers. First, I clone this repo into my local folder c/sample-app/sample-app-mysure-python. Now I need to modify the .env file at the root of this repo to include the configuration values to run the app. Now I need to generate these values on the Apps and Keys page in my DocuSign developer account. Under Apps and Integration Keys, I select Add App and Integration Key. I'll call my app MySure and copy the GUID so I can paste it into the .env file. I also need to add one secret key and copy its value as well. Remember, the secret key value is only displayed once, so it has to be copied when it's created. I also need to add a redirect URI by selecting Add URI, entering HTTP localhost port 3000 /callback, and clicking Save. Next, I paste the integration key GUID as the value of the DS client ID and my secret key GUID as my DS client secret into the .env file and save it. Don't worry about other values at this time, but these values are needed to support using payment gateway as well as using JWT authentication. To run the app on your machine, you'll need Python installed. To install Python, go to python.org and download Python. Next, you'll need to install NPM on your development machine. NPM is a package manager for Node.js and can be downloaded and installed from npmjs.com/getnpm website. I open a console window and navigate to the folder where I cloned the repo. If you don't yet have pip installed, use py-m pip install-u pip to install it. I type npm install and the npm package manager will download all node dependencies onto my machine. After this is done, if you don't have a virtual env installed, use pip-free install-u virtual env. Next, I create my virtual environment using virtual env venv. To activate my virtual environment, I use cd venv slash scripts and then activate. Then I go back cd slash dot dot slash. To run Flask first, I upgrade Flask with pip install dash dash upgrade Flask. I then type pip install dash r requirements.txt to install the Python packages on my backend. At this point, I'm ready to run the backend. To run the backend, I need to use Flask. I type flask run dash dash port 5001 to run Flask listening to port 5001. And now I can run the frontend UI from a different console window that I open. I type npm start to start the node server on my machine. NPM then launches my default browser and goes to localhost port 3000 to run my local copy of MySure. If everything was configured correctly, I authenticate using authorization code grant and make API calls to DocuSign for my developer machine. I select login with your developer account to log in. The second option will not work as I haven't configured the app for JWT grant authentication. This consent dialog is shown because it's the first time I'm using this integration key and I need to consent to having this app use my account credentials. Once I select accept, I can use MySure on my local machine. Now I show how to add another sign here tab to the document. Find the app slash document.py file and go to line 74. The sign here variable you see here is one of the objects used to call the SDK to add a sign here tab. Copy and paste it to create a sign here to variable. The original sign here tab used an anchor string, which is based on finding certain text in the document. I can also use fixed positioning by adding X position and Y position. I also need to add the document ID and page number fields. I also need to add sign here to the array of tabs assigned to the signer object since tabs are associated with specific recipients. Now I'll stop Flask, then run it again for the changes to take effect. I don't need to restart Node. To see these changes, I go to Buy New Insurance and complete the form for a car. On the Buy New Insurance document, under the last sentence, I see an additional sign here tab. Here are some additional developer resources to help you with DocuSign APIs. Thank you for watching this screencast. I hope you find it useful. If you are watching this from YouTube channel, please post questions and comments below the video or email us at developers@docusign.com.